Hey there, Carly and Psychedelic Nerd viewers. Today, I am not so much talking about a particular band or group or anything, as much as I am talking about a way to listen to music. Most of you probably have MP3 players, or iPods or something, but I tend to stick to more traditional means of listening to music. I've had the same CD player since I was about in the fourth grade, and I still have it today, and it still works. But my favorite way to listen to music is actually listening to vinyl. And I do have a record player, and I have a record collection, and I'm going to show you that today. This is my record player. Not entirely sure if you can see it, but I got this a couple years back, and it's not an original record player, not like a 1960s original or anything, but it's very, very nice, and I can play not only records, but I can also play CDs and 8-tracks and listen to the radio. It's a pretty cool gadget, but I have to admit that I really mostly use it for listening to records. I don't have a super huge extensive record collection or anything, but I will show you some of the records that I do have. The Beatles White Album, David Cassidy, David Cassidy is some of that embarrassing music that you don't want to admit that you like, but you kind of do because it's kind of really good. And this is kind of like the one thing that I'm... Okay, yeah. You know what? I like David Cassidy. Sue me. Herman's Hermits? Peter Noon? ABBA? John Denver? Classic, classic, classic. The Carpenters. I spent my entire sophomore year trying to sing like Karen Carpenter, only to realize that I can't. The most extensive part of my collection has to do with the Monkees, because, once again, they are my favorite band out of all of them, and I get teased a lot for it, but I do love them so much. This was the very first record that I ever got. My English teacher was at a garage sale, and she found this one in Pisces, Aquarius, Capricorn, and Jones. And at the time, I did not have a record player to play these on, so I just had to look at them and watch them be all pretty. But now I can actually play them, and it is awesome. So yeah, I have every Monkees record that they made in the 1960s when all four of them were together. Once Peter split the group, they had maybe one or two with just Mike, Mickey, and Davey. I do not have those, but I will probably get them someday. This is just kind of my prized possession of the collection. This is a Davy Jones 1965 album. I got this for $10, but the guy who sold it to me told me that the sticker itself that's on the record is worth $10 on its own, so I can imagine what this whole thing is worth. But honestly, money isn't a really big deal to me with these kind of things. I just enjoy listening to them, and that's really why I think I like to collect them, is because I can listen to them.
Away with you, yes I do.